To round off this section on the introduction to Emma, a comment on the artistry of the novelist is really called for. This novel is very professionally set. The artist gives the actions and the settings such detailed descriptions. Jane Austen writes like an artist throughout the story, giving the main action and the particulars of the environs with such detail, such precision, such accuracy and beauty, really, in many respects. The elegance of the prose is really superb, I think. Generally, as well, this novel and its entire production, the novel is a production. The way it presents itself is a piece of finished art. There's such a flourish to the fact of the novel in its published form. And as one reads it, it's an accomplished performance from the first word to the very, very last. You really feel that Jane Austen is in the full flow of her mastery of the art of writing, that she feels herself to be a professional novelist and to be a novelist of high calibre. Although she's not being arrogant, although she's not showing off, although she's not being hackneyed and taking on any form of stylization, she has realised herself in this novel, absolutely. It is a tremendous production. And I think that the idea that there has been in the past that Jane Austen didn't see herself as a professional writer, didn't see herself as a professional artist, has to be exploded simply by reading this novel. I just don't think anyone reading it could realistically, especially given, you know, all the social change that has occurred around women and women working and women acquiring educations now and being able to, you know, really take on full professional status. I think in today's world that we can see easily that this is what Jane Austen was doing, you know, leading the vanguard at a much, much earlier date. Although the family, Jane Austen's immediate family, didn't tend to like to promote the idea that she was a professional writer or that she saw herself as a professional writer, nonetheless, this quote taken from Jane Austen, Her Life and Letters, a Family Record, written by William Austen Lee and Richard Arthur Austen, would belie that. All through this year and the early part of the next, Emma was assiduously worked out. Although polished to the highest degree, it was more quickly composed than any previous work and gave evidence of a practised hand. And I think that is something about Emma that one can tell as well. Although it has this immense writing skill to its entire production, there is this idea as well. You can feel the facility with which the author has written. You can feel the pace and the speed with which she was able to construct this plot just from the style of the language. She really had reached the acme of her artistic powers. I talk a little in the next video about the setting of Emma, and I make some references to it being at points seeming a little bit like a play. The close arena of the town of Highbury, although we feel the outlying connections. But just as with a play, a Shakespearean play, for example, where messages come in from all these different places, far and wide, that's also sort of true in this novel, that the main action is set in this crucible of Highbury village. And because of the nature of the romantic comedy of the plot, we can sometimes very much feel that we are in a play. And this novel reminds me, not that I think Jane Austen ever was here, but it reminds me a little of the architectural artwork of the Teatro Olimpico or Teatro all'Antica, in Sabbioneta near Mantova or Mantua in Italy. This Renaissance theatre was designed by Vincenzo Scamozzi, and it is a really, really beautiful theatre. It, though, as well has this sense of being in camera. There is this, there's the seating, and above that, a semicircular colonnade with the Roman muses, statues of the Roman muses and gods of the arts. And then there's the stage, of course, which has setting of sort of Renaissance streets, all built in wood, or a Renaissance street but built in wood. And then the walls are decorated between the audience and the stage. The walls are decorated with these wonderful frescoes showing the countryside, the environs, and above that, painted into the walls, frescoes of an imaginary audience peering over an imaginary balcony, looking down on the action, the audience, and the stage. But there is, in this theatre, this wonderful sense of cohesion and being contained in a whole world. The theatrical experience is a whole world. You're meant to feel that somehow you are caught up in this microcosm of the macrocosm as you experience this play, that it's a totally embracing experience. And it's well worthwhile visiting the theatre if you have the opportunity. But there's something in the construction of Emma which really puts me in mind of, again, this type of theatrical experience which would be to be had in the Teatro Olimpico in Sabbioneta. Thanks for listening. I hope it's been interesting.